Hi everyone, this is Balazs from RacingBrick. This is my second review from the June 2023 Technic releases. You could already see the one about the John Deere Skidder. The link is in the top right corner as always. Today, I'm reviewing the second largest set in this batch, the 42158 NASA Mars Rover Perseverance. I mentioned this set in my preview video and speculated a bit about it, but at the time there were no real high-resolution photos and details, so let's start with the box now. The front of the box features the rover doing its thing in a random red desert. Just kidding, I know we are on Mars, but those tracks on the ground are very suspicious. It might be fake, just saying. In the corner is the logo for the AR Experience app. This is the same app that gave us the unforgettable experience with the pullback Technic Mustang and Porsche cars. Don't laugh. Unfortunately, the update isn't here yet and I don't have a preliminary access. Sariel was lucky enough to get a beta version. If you are interested in the features of the app, check out his video. I will now focus on the details of the build, the technical solutions and the functions, and we'll do another video about the AR part when the final version is released. I will link that one here as well. On the back of the box, we see the rover along with the helicopter, some features explained on the side images, and some potential details about the AR app. Let's open the box now. The set has 1,132 pieces. It is 10 plus, which helps avoiding the plain black box of the 18 plus sets. The price is 95 euros or $100 and it will be available from the 1st of June in Europe and in the APAC region, but the Americas will have to wait until the 1st of August. The set includes 8 numbered bags with 4 building phases, 1 unnumbered bag with the wheels, 2 sticker sheets and the instructions. One of the sheets is the regular type, the other has a nice metallic finish. The instructions have nothing extra at the beginning and I'm still disappointed with them. The app might have a lot of useful information about the rover, but I would have liked to see some information here as well. In the end, there are a few pages about the features, then a page about the app with no special details, a nice double photo with the real rover, and that's it. Here's the part list. You can pause the video if you are interested. Now let's start building. We will begin with the Ingenuity helicopter, and this part will be the core. It's a fairly simple design. The main components are made of a few simple Technic parts. Then comes the first golden metallic sticker with the solar panel on top, but we won't stop here. This 2x2 brick must be completely covered with the stickers. Once that's done, it's attached to the bottom and the helicopter is ready. One small criticism. Ingenuity's main tool is the camera array on the bottom, so that shouldn't be missing from this sticker. Then we start to build the rover. Make sure the triangular markings on those weird gears line up. It's a pretty ingenious design. The flags are held by these clips, but also guided by the teeth of the rounded gears. And what is this thing? This is exactly why I would prefer to see information in the instructions. Maybe we'll get details in the app once the build is complete, but we shouldn't wait until then. Oops, where's the last one? Here you are. I suggest using this great NASA page during building. I put a link in the description. There you can see the rover in 3D and find information about many components. This is the power source, the MMRTG, which converts heat from the radioactive decay of plutonium into electricity using something called the Seebeck effect. This will be the cover of the power source. The assembly isn't very stable, but it will be better when all the pins are in place. These axles aren't part of the original design, but they allow us to control the robot arm. A little repetition on the horizon, we have to build this assembly 4 times and those pins with pinholes are still annoyingly hard to push in, especially when there are 2 of them. They help to form the octagonal shape of the rear section, by the way. It's a tricky assembly, especially if you want to do it with a big camera in front of your head. Here's this orange flower part that seems to be pretty odd in this construction. It goes here and apparently its purpose is to block the rotation of the mechanism. Why an orange flower? I have no idea. Assemblies are attached to each other, and then comes the big turntable, brand new in white. Yes, these are the parts that will never come apart again. We are building these side panels, and then I would need yet another pin with pinhole, but I don't seem to have any. This could be my very first missing piece. Nope, still not. Pro tip, never throw away the plastic bags until you finish a building phase. So that's the end of phase 1. In phase 2, we are going to add this module here first. Then comes this cover assembly, and after that this cross block. I'm really not sure how this is going to work. At first I thought we are brick building a differential or something like that, but not anymore. I added GPL and NASA stickers, then comes this double-decker linear actuator assembly that attaches to the other axle coming off the rear end. It should work like this somehow, but no, I still need to extend the linear actuator a bit to make it work. Okay, it is in place. So that's the way it works. I think that one is going to extend the base of the robot arm. I'm going to change the build order a little bit here. Before I finish the body, I will move on to the suspension and wheels, because I want to show you how this rather ingenious steering system works. This is one side of the suspension already built. We've got lots of black bushes in there, the new flip-flop L-beam, the 7-module long flip-flop beam in black, and these glow-in-the-dark bars that were probably used to give you some nice parts in your inventory, if you are using the kit for parts, since they are completely hidden. Both assemblies are ready to go. Mount them to the body and now install the wheel supports at the four corners. This is an important step as shown in the instructions. The lever must be in this position and the axle should point outwards. I will try to show you what's happening here. As you can see, the position of the axle with the knob is really important because it affects how the outer wheels are positioned. If it is on one side, roughly in this position, then all the wheels are straight. When we turn the knob in this position, we steer normally, meaning the wheels turn to steer the rover left or right. However, when I push the axle to the other position, two things happen. I can no longer turn the knob because the cross block gets stuck in that slot, and in the meantime the outer wheels turn in a position that allows that 360 rotation in place. Many things are unsecured, so everything is still very shaky, but I hope you could see how this clever solution works. Now it's time to jump back, remove the suspension and install all the missing exterior elements. Here's a small wheel arch that is definitely not being used as the name suggests, but as a top cover for the sample handling system. This thing here is also part of the suspension, it's called, surprisingly, a differential. So, everything is assembled now until the end of bag 3. Yes, I had some of the wheel supports the wrong way around before, but hopefully you could see the steering principle, I'm not going to take it apart again. Things are a little more stable now, so I can demonstrate the two steering modes again. By more stable I mean improved, but as you can see it's still a little wobbly here and there. In the final phase we build a mast and all the equipment on top of it with a nice mix of Technic and system building solutions. Apparently I was right in the preview video, because that is a white carrot piece that is part of the weather station. A little tinkering and the mast is in place. Here's a pretty cool mixed construction Technic using a cross axle, 1x1 bricks with axle holes and minifig neck brackets. This becomes the aft crossbeam with an aluminum plate in the middle that has silicon chips with more than 10 million names on them. This is the ultra-high frequency antenna that sends data to Earth using the Mars orbiters as relays. This is one of the rear hazard avoidance cameras and another will be added soon. This piece, which is new in gold, represents the tubes of the cooling loops on the heat exchangers. We will add a few more markers, then this sticker will be the primary calibration target for the Mastcam Z camera system, which in reality looks like this. This steering wheel with the gold piece is the, shall we say, entry point of the sampling equipment in the belly of the rover. Here are the front husk cams and the high gain antenna used for direct communication with Earth. We are nearing the end and starting to build the arm. This assembly here with the worm gear and the other parts isn't quite as obvious in the instructions, but this is how you need to get all the things aligned and this is what you end up with. It's nice to see a status check in the manual. The rod on the left controls the horizontal movement and the one on the right controls the vertical movement. Here are the rover and mission nameplates on the arm, then comes the complex assembly at the end of the arm with the coring drill, Sherlock and Watson camera and detector modules, and the pixel X-ray spectrometer on the other side. The final step is to attach the turret to the arm, and that's it. A few pages explain how the arm works and how the various moving components should be placed in a storage position, and then we are really finished. So, here is our completed Perseverance model, and I have to say I'm glad it was released as a Technic set rather than an Icons build. Technic kind of suits the look and pure functionality of this machine. Of course, it could be more detailed with more system pieces, but this way you don't have to worry about accidentally ripping off a lot of things while touching the parts or playing with the functions. Size-wise, it is not very big, here are a few other Space and Technic models for comparison. Now, let's see all the features. The helicopter is small but quite playable, and there seems to be a fascinating well-hidden 1:10 gearing ratio between the two propellers. The mast can be moved to an upright position and needs to be secured with this pin here. The camera array can be rotated and also tilted. The robot arm can be controlled with the two white connectors at the rear, extending the arm takes some time. The second part has to be unfolded manually, and the turret can also be moved around on that ball joint. There is a pretty big difference between the fully extended position and the storage position. The steering system works as I showed during the building. The most effective is probably the 360 rotation, which works quite well. The other steering mode sort of works, but it depends on the surface, and because of the slack of the steering components, the wheels are still a bit wobbly and don't always find the right direction. So, the principle of the steering is cool, but the execution is a victim of the scale and the inaccuracy of the LEGO parts that had to be used. Also, the suspension is more of a theoretical feature, the rover won't really overcome many obstacles on its own. As I mentioned before, I don't have the updated app yet, so I can't show you the AR features just yet. I will do a second video when the new version is released. Since I don't have the full picture, I won't rate the set at this point. Perseverance goes into standby mode and waits for the update transmission. But in the meantime, please let me know what you think in the comments. How do you like the build itself, the technical solutions, the details, the look? Let's talk about it. If you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe with notifications as more exciting LEGO videos are coming soon. See you next time, bye bye.